Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, Mrs. Isi. Good morning, my lovely friends. First of all, let us give thanks to the God who has given us the grace and health so that we can carry out the online class without a problem. Today we have online classes in pragmatics, and the theme of our presentation from group 2 is speech act. The first presentation is me, Siti Mukaromah. The second is Miss Indah Nur Hidayah, and the third is Mr. Andreas Nur Cahaya Utama. The first presentation will discuss about concept of speech act. The philosopher of speech act is J.L. Austin, because the speech act theory was introduced by J.L. Austin. Austin was not a linguist at all, but a philosopher. He is working at Oxford University in 1940s and 1950s. The appearance of the most influential collecting of Austin paper in How to Do Things with Words, which published in 1962. Austin is the person who is known as pragmatics. Speech acts is a subfield of pragmatics that studies how words are used not only to present information, but also to carry out action. Austin defined speech act as the action performed in saying something. Next concept of speech act. Speech act theory said that the action performed when an utterance is produced. Austin used the term speech act to refer an utterance and total situation in which the utterance is used. In saying a sentence, the speaker not only says something, but also acts something. For example, what do you want to drink? In that sentence, the speaker not only asks for an answer, but also takes action on something that is offering. Austin made threefold distinction of utterance, the elocution, elocution, and perlocution. Locution is the actual words uttered. It means the literal meaning of utterance, the basic form of the words uttered, and the act of saying something. Example, I'm thirsty. The locution or literal meaning from the sentence is that the speaker is really thirsty. His throat needs water. Other sentence, it's really cold. The basic act of utterance that speaker made, it is locutionary act. Elocution. Elocution is the force or intention behind the words, or it means the specific purpose that the speaker have in mind, the true intention of speech, and the speaker's intention from the utterance. For example, I'm thirsty. The elocution or the speaker's intention, it is the speaker ask for a drink. Another example, could you please close the window? The elocution or the speaker's mind that the speaker feels good. Perlocution. It is the effect of the elocution on the hearer. Or it means the hearer's reaction. It refers to the effects which may be intended or not. The utterance has on the behavior, thoughts, and feelings of the hearer. Example, I'm thirsty. Perlocution of the hearer's thought, it can be that the hearer brings drinking water to the speaker. And the example, it's really cold in here. Perlocution, or the hearer responds by saying, let me close the window. The same locution could have different elocutionary force in different contexts, depending on the context of utterance. Example, do you have an agenda tonight? It can mean any of the following. The speaker wants to know the hearer. The speaker wants to take a walk with the hearer, or the speaker thinks that the time is out. The same words can be used to perform different speech act, and different words can be used to perform the same speech act. Example, requesting someone to stop smoking. The sentence can be like this, do not smoking, or it's really comfortable without pollution, or could you please not smoke here, or isn't that sweets better than cigarettes, right? Okay, that's all my presentation. I ask apologies to you all because my slide was error, and I cannot record very well. I'm really sorry. I have a try. Sudah berusaha semaksimal mungkin, 2 hari nggak tidur, cuma ngerjain ngerekam, but belum berhasil. I'm so sorry. That's all yang bisa saya presentasikan. Mohon maaf yang sebesar-besarnya. Thank you so much. And the second presenter is Miss Indah. Time is hers. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.